Shout out to this Moneybag Mop, man. Here with my man Vic, Cream City TV, man. Check us out. Subscribe us, like us, Facebook, YouTube, Instagram, Cream City TV, man. And we here with my man Vic. Alright, we're gonna jump right into it. Man, what's some of the stuff? How did you get started, man? What motivated you to be a barber?
Oh man, you know, I started off, my cousin told me to get into it. He opened a shop, and I was coming back from being locked up, so I had to do something different with my life, so I ended up jumping to cutting hair, and I ain't looked back since then.
Oh, for sure, man, but like you said, man, out of that turmoil, you know what I'm saying, you turned it into being something positive, you know what I'm saying, and I really do commend you on that, but like I said, man, other than that, what was some of the things that kind of like got you into the being the barber road? Did you have any role models or people that you looked up to and was like, okay, well, he was a nice barber, let me, you know what I'm saying, try to model him?
Well, I always liked cutting hair growing up. I always cut my little brothers up, so I was like decent already doing it when I first started. I just enjoyed it because you get to talk to so many different people. You build relationships with different people over the years. Like some of my clients have been cutting for like 12 years. I've been in this shop for 12 years, so you know, I've been here, it's been a long journey. I mean, I appreciate it and I thank everything and all my clients for sticking with me. Because you know, when I first started out, it was kind of rough. I didn't know if I wanted to do this, it was slow. Then I ended up picking up a couple years later, so now here I am today. I mean, brand my own name, Skinny Fresh, check me out.
How long have you been barbering?
I've been doing it for about 15 years, but I've been at this shop for 12 years.
Okay.
I've only been at one shop, no other shop.
Oh, for sure, man. But that motivation of speaking, like you said, man, everything that you said was good. Now, how did you end up meeting Flip? Or was it like a spur of the moment type of thing? Or somebody introduced you to him, you bumped elbows with him, you said,
well,
you know what I mean?
Flip's my cousin.
Okay.
So he was always cutting my hair. And he always used to whisper in my ear, like, yo, come on, let's do this haircut and stuff. You know, take this to the next level. And that's when I ended up getting locked up, so I didn't take it as serious. But then, through our little letters, you know, he was like, yo, when you get out, I got the shot. Come through, we're gonna make it happen.
So this was before everything perspired and everything?
So growing up, he always cut me and all my friends up. So a lot of my friends still get haircuts by him, because that's who they was being cut up by. But a lot of my friends come to me as well. So, you know, I know him for like my whole life.
So you kind of like, we basically just say you owe most of it. I ain't gonna say all of it because, like I said, you're a self-made man. But most of it to Flip.
Yep. He helped a lot.
Okay. Can you elaborate on that relationship you had with Flip growing up? Or?
I mean, growing up, we was always together, kicking it. You know what I mean? We was real close. Like one of my best friends. You know, we've been through a lot. So, you know, but he was always the one that used to tell me, like, yo, cut hair. I'll do it. Cut hair. Come on. And I wasn't like, really into that because, you know, I was out here in the streets, you know, not caring, just doing whatever, working little fast jobs, you know what I mean, McDonald's, Taco Bell, you know, when I was like 17, you know, and then, you know, like I said, my life took a change. In 2003, when I got out of high school, I got locked up, so,
okay,
so I know how to make it.
Anything you want to tell the barbers after you, or people that's trying to come up and make something of themselves, like, you know what I'm saying, it's not about the race, the sprint,
yeah.
You know what I'm saying, it's a marathon.
It's a marathon, exactly, so, I mean, for a lot of you young barbers that want to cut hair, it takes time and effort. You got to put the time to get the people. You know what I mean? You're not going to come and just be busy right away. You know what I mean? You're going to be there days where you're only cutting one or two people. But it takes time. Everybody wants to be a barber until it's time to become a barber. You know what I mean? You got to grind. You got to put the hours in. You know what I mean? I do 12-hour shifts sometimes. You know what I mean? You got to satisfy the people. You know I mean? The people come first. You know what I mean? I go off of their schedule. It's my time, but they go off my time, but I go off their schedule. I mean, I get them in when I can, so.
And I heard you mention the 12-hour shifts, man. What's some of the motivational factors that keep you going, keep you on a day-to-day grind and in and out, like you said, just putting that time in, man? What keep you going, keep you level with it?
What keeps me going is my kids, man. I got four kids, and I mean, they keep me motivated. I strive to give them something different that I never had growing up. So I just enjoy doing things with them and be able to provide for them some of the things that they need when they want it, for doing good deeds, like this, good grades. You know, just motivating my kids, letting them know that their father growing up didn't have a lot of the stuff they had, so this is why I'm working hard. And another thing is, they're going through, you know, like I said, you make friends. Some of the people that I've met through cutting hair are like real close friends with me, and I do stuff, you know, as far as like family events, you know, they introduce me to their family, you know. So it's just, you know, it takes time. Like he said, it's not the race, it's a marathon.
You said you didn't have that motivational factor when you was growing up. Elaborate on that, you know what I'm saying? Like about, I don't want to get into, you know what I'm saying, in depth, but you know what I'm saying? Just like the step of the household. Was it single father, single mother?
See, I had a single mother growing up. My father used to visit me on the weekends, but, you know, it's a lot different. It's a lot different growing up with both parents compared to just having one. I mean, because when you're growing up, you need both parents to see. I mean, your dad tells you, teaches you how to be a man. Mother teaches you, gives you a little leeway. So, and I see that now with my kids. You know what I mean? I'm experiencing it as a father and seeing the difference that it was growing up with me not having a father because I didn't have him when he was there. You know, until I got older and I moved with him. But, you know, it's just, you see the difference.
Okay, man. But like I said, man, I don't want to take up too much of your time, man. Boy Skeet, man, I really do appreciate the video. Like I said, the interview, Cream City TV, man, check us out. Subscribe us. Make sure you follow us on Facebook. Like I said, hit that like button, hit that subscribe button. And my man got something else to say.
Yeah, man, shout out to Cream City TV, man, for giving me the opportunity just to shoot this little video with him and give you guys a perspective on my life and how I became a barber and why I enjoy doing it.
Cream City TV, we out.
Skeety Fresh, man. Come holler at me, man. 8th and National.